It's Caroline from the Arty Crafty Tart. Welcome back to my channel. And this is part two of the little mini journal I made a couple of days ago. So last night we got as far as making the basic journal with all the pockets in like that. And I said I'd come back on to decorate it. So here I am. I've got some bits and pieces here. Journaling cards. I've got envelope templates cut out. Got a label for the front. I've got all this cut out from Stamperia Spring Botanic page. That's one. I've got some stuff in here from Foxy Crafters and a little tag, the same as the other one. So yeah, let's get on and do this. So I might have to go on a search for some other little bits of the mini ephemera that Tracy has done, Tracy Fox, because they're really cute for the pockets like that. I thought that was really nice. So let me just grab some of those. Should be to hand here. Let's flick it through. Let me get there. So there's some more tags there. My printing went a bit awry on those sheets. As you can see, they're rubber. It is. Get the folder out a bit easier. I downloaded as well there that were pre-printables from Pinterest. Okay, back. And I think I love the butterflies. Some of them anyway. Hopefully that's good enough. It's 7:30 in the evening. So the sun's going down, and even though I'm in my conservatory and the light is brilliant in here, it is disappearing. So back to work today for UK and the US after an extra day's holiday, which is much appreciated. But unfortunately, this morning at work was like Monday morning and Tuesday morning rolled in together. So, queue at the door, people in and out all day, all morning. But I don't mind because I do enjoy my job most of the time. You can whiz through the video if you don't want to sit and watch me inking up these little cute little bits. I've treated myself to Photoshop and have been watching videos about how to make layered pages for scrapbooking and things like that. So, you never know, I might even sell some stuff on my Etsy shop, which is a bit sparse at the moment, so I've got quite a few bits to put in there. I won't carry on with that for ages. So what I did with the other one, to stiffen up this cover a little bit, was put a journaling card in there, and I've got some that I've done with quite thick card. So if I put the bigger ones in there, let's find a picture that fits. That's okay. And that one's okay. So I will ink this round. This, I'll cut out of this. Sorry. Make you sick. This nesting die that I think I got from AliExpress, and I do like it. I mean, it was pennies really. But I think it's very effective. I have got one of those deckled edge rulers, but it's no good for card really. So let's do this one. And this is Vintage Photo, for anybody that would like to know. Good old Vintage Photo. Well, let's just make sure I can get the glue out the pot, which is... I'm using Cosmic Shimmer for this because it dries nice and quickly. I'd probably be okay with glue stick, but I'm using this at the moment. So that's our first one. That can go in there. Now let's put some things in here and do this pocket. So I think I'll put a bit of lace on it. Put lace on this one. Or maybe. Yeah, a bit of music paper. And I must apologise if the sound hasn't been too bad. First of all, I don't like to speak too loudly when my neighbours are in the garden and the door to the conservatory is open. Because I think I've gone mad talking to myself. And secondly, I've bought myself a microphone, which would be great, but there isn't a socket for it in my iPhone, so I've got a. I'm going to set up my iPad for it. So let's have that little guy on there. Go. Yes, so I'll set up my iPad, then I put the microphone on, which will do two things. You'll be able to hear me better for a start, and secondly, it'll cut out all the paper noises and things like that a bit, which can be quite annoying at times. I know that. Okay, so that's that one done, and I think I'll put some lace on this one because it's a dark one and it'll show up better. Okay, Oh, that wasn't a good idea. Oh! I don't know whether you can see that. I put my Fabri-Tac upside down with the lid on because I hadn't got very much of it left. And now I have a pile of scissors and cutters all stuck together. Oh dear. Never mind. It's coming off okay. It's just going to take a little while to do it. Never mind. So. Oh, well, that'll teach me. So the result of that is I've got no Fabri-Tac. So I will have to use this. I've got some fabric glue. It's only the cheap stuff, but let's see how that works. The only thing with this is it's not glue and it's got a huge great nozzle. Like that. So I'll have to decant some of it. I hope it dries clear. It certainly doesn't stick as instantly as Fabri-Tac. No good at all. So, option number two is this one. There, that's better. Immediately. What should I put on here? I think. These are great, really, because they're so small, they take no time at all to adorn with pretty things. So, this one, what should I do? Very old book page. So old. The pages have gone brittle and they break rather than tear. It's an ancient copy of Uncle Tom's Cabin. Somebody was thrown away. There, I think. That would be the right little mess here. No. This one. A little bee on it. No, that's too small. Looks like it's going to be this one. And the next one. Look over there. Before I managed to glue it to something. Oh, what should we do on here? Let's put that bit of lace on there, I think. I do apologise if I'm muttering. It's like I'm talking to myself. And clearly I'm not. Well, I am at the moment, but hopefully I won't be. Let's take the white edge off that a wee bit. It's quite pretty. One best. Music paper, I think. Some nice simple octaves. So, a question for you. Do any of you sell your journals, albums, whatever you make, at craft fairs? I haven't really done many craft fairs. I struggle with carrying things to and fro because I've got inflammatory arthritis and so I can't walk very far, and so I find it really tiring. But I'd like, if they can be productive, then I'll find someone to come with me and do it that way. But the one that I did go to, the most recent one that I went to, I paid for the car park, I paid for the stall. It was a very good craft fair, a lot of footfall. But I really ended up not covering my costs. So I'd spent all day there. Petrol, entry fee, you name it, and ended up not even breaking even, really. Because you have to walk around and buy something. Well, you know, you don't have to. But you do. So, yeah, I found word of mouth and Etsy to be my best my best bets at the moment, and it'd be interesting to find out how you guys sell yours. I know a lot of you have got Etsy shops, but that's sort of, once you've uploaded, that sort of runs itself. So I was wondering about any other ideas anybody has. Right, we're on the last little page here. So, what should we do? A bit more lace, I think. Yeah, so if you've got 5 minutes and could put something in the comments, or I've also got a Facebook page called The Arty Crafty Tart, and would welcome anybody to come join me on that. I put all sorts of different bits on there. Haven't been so productive on there recently. I've sort of put more effort into my YouTube page, so I must put some more stuff on my Facebook page too. There's a nice ant here. Got several of those in there. Oh, that's nice. Like that one. Yep. Sold. So if I make this much mess with a journal this size, you can only imagine the sort of mess I make with a full-size journal. There we go. Right, now I need another big card for this pocket here. I like the look of that, that's beautiful, but it's too big. And I don't want to reduce that in size at all, and that one's too big too. That one. Now I just need to fill the pockets. 2, 4, 6. So I need about 12 bits and pieces really, somewhere along the way. So I've cut these out from a little die, which was another very inexpensive one. And it makes rather a super little envelope. I do find inking them up before I stick them down much easier. So you can either put double-sided tape on these or a smidgen of glue. I used some of no sideways ones. Medieval Mirage is digital downloads. Let's have a quick look. Sepia. These looked rather nice. There's a little one there. Let's keep that one out. And some of those. And pockets. Little envelope there that I could use, and there. This is just printed out on inkjet printer paper. So I don't want the added bulk, and I find the smaller things are, the clumsier they look with thick card. You want to stamp on these as well. I think they look quite nice with vintage photo stamping on them. There we are. There's a sweet little poppy there, which would be even better if it was the right way out. That's cute. Yeah, I think I'll use that. colour. I've got one more printed out, so. I'll just do that one. That'd be one for. The score line. That'd be one for each of the little signatures that are in it. So, yeah, going back to my Facebook page, it'd be lovely if you became a family on that. Build that up a little bit. Okay, that's that. Got all sorts on there. I also belong to Nina Rubina's Art Journal Prompts and More. And so there's some artwork on there as well as crafting. And some more different things. I used to make jewellery, which I don't really do anymore. I've got plenty of beads and things, but but I can use those for bangles. Yeah, so I sort of gradually moved on from beads, gemstones, and general jewellery making. I find this more rewarding. You can put more of your own imagination into it. It doesn't have to cost you a fortune. So yeah, from jewellery making I went on to art journaling, which is where I came across Nina's page, which I love and I'm still a member of. I haven't done quite so much art recently because I've been doing this a bit more. But I must get back into that. The trouble is I get so filthy when I'm doing my art. I get covered, my hands get all stained because I'm a bit messy with it all. But I will get back into that and probably do a few videos as well. But I thoroughly recommend her page if any of you like to do a bit of art journaling. They've got a nice prompt set up, which actually includes a bit of crafting as well. It's not just art. So yeah, that was that's basically the last 2 years. So I've been doing more art and craft, and actually more craft than art. Okay, so there's our envelopes, and one can go in each signature. Now I need some. Oh, I've got another one here. No, one, please, Emma. I won't make you sit through all that lot again. Right. There we are. That fits on there beautifully. I could have put some tags in here, obviously, but I'm going to stick with these bits for now. Otherwise, we'll be going on and on for hours. I don't take me even longer to upload it. Then you'll get bored and I'll get upset and we'll all end in tears. Cute little journaling card. What else have we got here? Use that hand over there. Or that's probably a bit big for that one, but that one would be I've already cut the edge of the page off anyway when I was printing it. Which is very clever. Not that one. Let's use this one. That one. So this again is a medieval odyssey from Medieval Mirage. She's got some fabulous digital downloads on her page, on her Etsy shop rather, on her page. She's also got a channel, YouTube channel, where she does some really good mixed media effects. And one of my videos I did was a slight adaptation on how she used craft, coloured craft card to bleed through a stencil to make some nice backgrounds, and I based mine on that, but I used tissue paper. And if you haven't had a look at that video and you like a bit of homemade background paper, then that's quite a good method. Right, so I'm going to cut it. Like a wine bottle label. Not that I've ever seen many of those. These are already inked, but I've got some cut edges that I want to get rid of. Sponge is starting to wear out, and when it wears out, you get all little pieces of sponge everywhere. So I can't cut these straight, but can't put them round either. Got something on that one. Try and blend it in. Okay. Now, I haven't overdone the tags and bits because I don't want to bore you to tears. Let's put some of these little ones in as well. To fill it up a bit. That's that blue one. And so they've each got something with a tag. So now the next thing I did, I've got some index cards and I use the reverse side. I'm going to cheat here. Or I would cheat if I could find the other paper maybe. Yeah. So I am going to cheat now and draw around this one. I know you can't do that, but it depends on. I'll give you a measurement actually, because if you do the tags, the library card holders, in the size that they come out, then your measurements will be the same as mine. So, let's do this. So it's 4.5 by 3, measuring without the tag included. So 3 by 4.5. For the library card, the index card, and that slots in there quite nicely because remember you've got the top and bottom taped together, so you can't, it won't go right to the edges. So I made 3 of these, but I'll only make 1 here and now, because they're all 3 the same. Just put the tabs in a slightly different place. And then I'm going to do the corners, ink the top, and all I did, self-explanatory really. I used my crocodile to punch a wee hole in the tag there. This time I'm going to use a silver grommet to match the ring on the tag that I've made. Put together, should I say, made it. that. I've only put it on the one, but you can put it in as many as you like. The little paper and silver tags I got from Amazon, and the little circular printouts of Tracy Fox. Little dangle which I've got the wrong way round, so it's not going to hang properly. It's like my fingers, these things. Right, let's turn it round. There we are, that's better. And that will go in there. And I will do two more of those, but not right now. And then we want something for the front. So I did pull out the label. There it is. These are some just free printables from Pinterest. And I'm just going to put that onto a piece of chipboard to pop it out from the cover a little bit. You might like to find a bit that fits a bit better, or cut a few more bits up to make it fit. But this again stiffens the cover. Fortunately, there are a lot of straight lines on here that I can go with. Probably still managed to get it crooked. So that's there, and I think on here, got a perfect label. There we are. All done. Mini number two. I might put these on my Etsy. If anybody's interested, before I do that, let me know. Get in touch. I will finish this one off with the cards there. The index cards. And that wraps up the little mini journal using the library card pockets. So I'll just give you a quick flip through. There we are. All done. Okay, thanks for watching. If you like what you've seen, please like and subscribe. And comment below if you've got any feedback for me or want to ask any questions. Yeah, thanks for watching. Bye for now.